Hello students, let us look at this another problem which again we will try to do using nodal analysis. The question asks, calculate the current through 2 ohm resistor using node analysis. See, if there would not have been written this node analysis, then there was no need for us to actually use node analysis, because this is a perfect problem for mesh analysis because it's all voltage sources. But since in the question they have asked to use nodal analysis, so we will use nodal analysis. So let us look first thing that we always do is we define the nodes and the reference node. So first node, let me say that, you know, this one is one single node. This totally is one single node. So that I will mark it as one node. Another one, this one is one single node. All this connection, this is another one node. So that is going to be my second node. So two nodes are over. Now coming between this, yes, I will have another node here. Okay. Then here also I will have a node. So that is going to be my fourth node. So this one was the third node and this is the fourth node. The last node or the fifth node would be this one. This complete stretch will be the fifth node. So I can mark the nodes. Now here, unlike in the previous problem, here we are having voltage source. So what is going to be the difference here? One of the things is, suppose it can be taken as a, you know, what we call generally as a super node, but right now it's not a super node. When we will discuss super node, that time you will understand. Anyway, so let me first name this node. This is the first node that I have to name. So let me name this first node as V1 or VA. Let me name it as VA. This is the second node. Let me name this as VB. Now here you have to be careful, because this one we have marking as the reference node. Now because we have marked this one as the reference node, so this here, the V will be equal to 0. So if this is 0, then here I told that there is another node. That node, whatever is the voltage, you know, whatever is the voltage there, that voltage V minus 0 is going to be equal to, sorry, that voltage V minus 0. So this is the V, this is 0 volt. So this will be 0. Okay. So between these two, what is going to be the voltage? So if this is V, this is 0, then V minus 0 is going to be equal to 20. Therefore, V should be equal to 20. So here, I will directly write 20 volt. Why? Because 20 minus 0 is going to give me 20 volt. So whenever you are seeing a voltage source like this, one of the things that you have to do is, if it is a positive, so here it is a positive one, so this one I will write it as 20 volt. Similarly here also, this is going to be 20 volt. Now this I have written as 20 volt only because, you have to be very careful, only because this is reference node. That means this side is all reference node, which is 0 volt. That's why 20 minus 0 is going to be 20 itself. If this would not have been 0, then I would not have been able to write this. I would have done something that is called as super node, that I will teach later. So anyway, I have defined the four nodes and the fifth one is the reference node. Generally, as you move forward, there is no need for you to write this too, because it's well understood that this is going to be 20 volt. If this is 0 volt, if this is 0 volt, then obviously this will be 20 volt. Now, if the batteries would have been reverse, that means this is negative, this is positive, then I would have written this side as minus 20 volt. You should remember it. Okay. What did I say? If I am defining the battery reverse, that means this is negative, this is positive, then this will be minus 20 volt. Okay. Based on that, so now let us do the problem. So here what do we see? We have to first arbitrarily define the direction of current. So I am arbitrarily defining. Let this direction let this one be this, let this one be this, here I am going to put a direction like this, here I can put it any way, let me put it like this, any direction, your wish. So once we have put this direction, then we will start writing the equation. So you all know the equation for current is higher potential minus lower potential, higher potential minus the lower potential divided by the resistance in between. So here I will write one by one. So this is current, first current, then current is moving like this. So this is higher, this is lower. So what I will write is, I'll straight away come to the point. So I will write KCL at mesh, not mesh, KCL at node A. So this is going to be our node A. Which one? This one. This one is going to be our node A. So generally, how you mark it? Okay, like this. So at node A, let me choose a different pen. So KCL at node A. So this is incoming current, so it is going to be positive. The next is outgoing current, so this is going to be negative. This one is also going to be outgoing current, so that will be also negative. So now higher potential is 20 minus VA divided by 1. Then I am having the second one, higher potential is VA, so VA minus 0 divided by 1, and here it is going to be VA minus VB divided by 0.5, that is going to be equal to 0. So as you know, the whatever is the denominator we are having, you have to multiply it with that. Even by taking the LCM of all the denominators also you can write, but generally for avoiding any sort of mistake, what I will say is always multiply it with the denominators directly. So multiply with 1, I am not going to write because there is no effect in multiplying with 1. I will just write 0.5. So when I multiply, I will get 20 into 0.5. So this whole equation, I have to multiply it with 0.5. So the equation is multiplied with, this whole equation is multiplied on both sides with 0.5. Here, if you multiply 0 with 0.5, it is anyway going to be 0 itself. So there is no point in multiplying that side. So what will I get? 0.5 into 20 is 10 minus 0.5 VA minus 0.5 VA, 0 is gone, minus 0.5, 0.5 cancel, so it is just minus VA plus VB is going to be equal to 0, from which I can take all the VAs together, I will get, so minus 0.5 minus 0.5 minus 1 together, I will get minus 2 VA plus VB is going to be equal to minus 10. So that is going to be my first equation for the first node. Okay. Now second equation, second unknown is going to be this node, which I am going to name it as B, because the voltage is VB, I am naming it as B. So the next equation will be KCL at node B. KCL at node B. So KCL at node B, I will get directly. So look at this equation. So as I have always said, higher potential minus low potential. So this is going to be incoming. So this is going to be positive. This is outgoing. So this will be negative. This is incoming. So this will be positive. So positive minus positive, positive, negative, positive. So let me write that. So it's going to be positive, negative, positive. Now let me write the values. So here the current is flowing from this side. So it is going to be plus VA minus VB divided by 0.5. minus, let me write the minus little bit closer so the equation is not too big. So minus of the second one is VB minus 0 divided by 2. The third branch is plus V, not V, it is 20. So it is higher potential minus lower potential. So higher potential is 20 volt because the direction of current is from here to here. The direction of current is like this. So this is the higher potential, 20 volt. So 20 minus VB divided by 1. That is going to be my total, that is equal to 0. So now multiplying it with, multiply with 0.5 as well as with multiplied with 2. So I have to multiply with 0.5 as well as with 0.2. Why 0.5? Because I want to cancel this second one. That means 0.5 because I want to cancel this one, 2 because I want to cancel this one. So let me write that equation for the same. So this whole equation is multiplied with 0.5 and 2. So you might be tempted, right? 0.5 into 2 is 1. So it's as good as multiplying it with 1. No, we are not multiplying it because we want to just multiply. We want to multiply it because we want to cancel this 0.5 and this 2 with this one for each case. So we have to be very careful. Okay, so let us start. So 0.5 and multiplied with this one, it will go, what will remain is 2. So 2 times VA minus 2 times VB. So the first one is over. Second one, if I multiply with 0.5 into 2, 2 and 2 will cancel. So what will remain will 0.5, so minus 0.5 VB. 0 is, no need to write 0. Then last one, plus, it's anyway, there is nothing to cancel. So 0.5 into 2, 0.5 into 2 is going to be 1. So 1 into everything, so it will be just plus 20 minus VB is equal to 0. So from this I can write 2VA and VB I can combine together. There is minus here, minus here, 2.5, 3.5. So minus 3.5 VB is equal to minus 20. This is going to be my second equation. So solving equation 1 and 2. That means for VA and VB, these two equations, 1 and 2, I will get the answer of VA as 11 and I will get VB as 12 volt. So 11 volt and 12 volt is going to be the answer. So based on that, as you can see, we have calculated VA and VB. So now, what is the question? The question is current through 2 ohms. So 2 ohms is basically this one, this current, the current that is this one. So it's easy to find out this current because just voltage VB minus 0 divided by 2 using the same equation, higher potential minus lower potential. So using that I will write, so current through 2 ohms is equal to higher potential is VB, lower potential is 0 divided by 2, which comes out to be 12 minus 0 by 2, which is going to be 6 amperes. It's very important that you write the units correctly. So 6 amperes. You try to solve the same problem using mesh analysis, you will get the same answer. So once again, this would have been a very good problem for mesh analysis, but since they have written nodal analysis here, I have chosen to do this problem using nodal analysis. Always remember this voltage that we have to write. If we are having a voltage source, then we should be able to write what is the voltage here. Then only we will be able to do. So all the node voltages we will have to write. Now you may be asking, sir, we are doing all the KCL in each and every node. Why did we miss out this node? Why didn't we write a KCL for this one or for this one or for that matter for any other problem? We need not find out. Why? Because the node analysis is done basically to find out VA and VB. So the node voltage is what we are trying to find out using node analysis. Remember this always. Node analysis is done to find out node voltages. Mesh analysis is done to find out the mesh currents. Don't forget this. Write this somewhere and keep. Node analysis is done to find out the node voltages, and mesh analysis is done to find out the mesh current. Thank you.